Let us look at subscriber address dialing in this slide. Refer to the figures that are appearing on your screen now. First one is decadic pulse dialing. This is a familiar rotary dialing which is obsolete now. The figure 1 shows the rotary dialer and the pulse dialing standards. We have seen this already in brief. This is also known as loop disconnect or DC signaling. If digit 8 is dialed, the DC loop is interrupted at a specific rate and also at specific durations 8 times. The pulse rate is 10 impulses per second and the interruption period is 67% make and 33% break. We have seen all this a short while ago. Let's look at the new figure. We look at DTMF dialing, which is an AC signaling. DTMF stands for dual tone multi-frequency. The modern signaling through phones etc. happens through DTMF signaling. This is also known as AC signaling and is another example of in-band signaling. Pulse dialing was slow and hence became obsolete, whereas DTMF is quite fast. We have seen all this. When a number is pressed, two separate tones are sent in rapid succession. The actual tones for each digit are shown in a matrix form. As each number has distinct set of tones, the switching system recognizes the number dialed. If you press digit 1, two tones are sent within 40 milliseconds, 1209 Hz and 697 Hz. The pause interval between these two digits is again 40 milliseconds. One tone 40 milliseconds, a pause for 40 milliseconds and the second tone for another 40 milliseconds. It's obvious tone dialing is very fast and hence call is processed quickly. The path setup for a rotary call is around 45 seconds, whereas for tone dialing this can be just 7 seconds. Tone dialing has virtually replaced pulse dialing entirely throughout the world. Refer to the new figure that's on your screen. This figure shows a concept of in-band signaling where dialing and speech occupy the same frequency band between 0 Hz to 4 kHz. The bandwidth of a typical telephone channel is up to 4000 Hz. The speech band occupies a bandwidth of 300 to 3400 Hz. If the signal frequencies are so chosen to be within the range of baseband telephone signal, then this type of signaling is referred to as voice frequency signaling. How many types of voice frequencies are there? The voice frequency signaling are classified into two classes, namely in-band signaling and out-of-band signaling. What is in-band signaling? We have seen this already in brief. Let's recall them quickly again. In in-band signaling, the control frequencies are within the speech band, typically in the range of 2280 or 2600 Hz. As this uses the same frequency band, it must be protected against limitations of speech. If a tone is around 2600 Hz and lasts for more than 50 milliseconds, the switching equipment recognizes this as a signaling component and not a speech component. What is out-of-band signaling? This signaling has frequencies above the voice band of 3400 Hz but below 4000 Hz. CCIT recommended frequencies are 3825 Hz but 3700 Hz and 3850 Hz are also being used. Out-of-band signaling is generally used in 4-wire E&M trunk circuits. What is E&M? 2 wires for voice path, an E lead and an M lead, plus an earth ground return. In this slide, let's look at the call flow sequence. The calling party goes off hook, the hook switch of the telephone shorts both the wires and creates a loop all the way up to the telephone exchange. The exchange senses a DC loop since DC current flows through the loop. Exchange acknowledges the calling party's request and extends a dial tone. The calling party starts dialing, either pulse dialing or DTMF tone dialing. Exchange collects the string of digits and analyzes them. Exchange locates where the called party is, he could be in any part of the world, and extends a ring signal to the called party through the distant exchange. Maybe a series of exchanges en route get involved in this. The distant exchange extends an alert signal to the call party whose telephone starts ringing. In the next step, local exchange extends a ring back tone, ring indication, to the calling party as well, just as an assurance that the call is under progress. The call party picks up the phone to answer the call. The alert signal to the calling party and ring back signal to the call party both are stopped. Both parties are ready now and they start speaking to each other. After the conversation is over, any one of the parties can disconnect by going on hook. This is sensed by the appropriate exchange, the local exchange or the distant exchange, and the call is disconnected. The billing for the entire duration of the call is computed and logged. This is a typical call flow that happens in a telephone conversation.